Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a free, complete course for the CCNA. If you like these videos, please subscribe to follow along with the series. Also, please like and leave a comment, and share the video to help spread this free series of videos. Thanks for your help. In this lab, we'll get some practice configuring static routes on Cisco routers. Actually, there are going to be two labs for day 11 of this course. This first one, where you will configure static routes, and then the next one, where you will troubleshoot an already configured network that has some problems. Anyway, in this lab, we want to configure the network to allow PC1 and PC2 to ping each other. I haven't done any pre-configurations on these devices at all, so we have to go in and configure the host names, IP addresses, etc. first. I chose not to do any pre-configurations so that you can get some extra practice with the basics, as repetition is very important in getting used to the CLI. So let's do the basic configurations for each device as instructed in step 1. I'll start on PC1 first. Click on Config, and the first thing we should configure is the gateway here. This is the address to which PC1 will forward packets, which are destined for a location outside of the local network. PC1's gateway is R1, so I'll put in R1's IP address, 192.168.1.254. Next, click on Fast Ethernet 0, which is PC1's network interface, and type in the IP address here, 192.168.1.1, and if you hit Tab, it automatically fills in the subnet mask for this Class C address, 255.255.255.0. Then, exit out. Now, don't worry about configuring the switches. If you want, you can go in and turn off unused interfaces, set interface descriptions, etc. for extra practice, but I think you'll get plenty of practice just by configuring the routers. So let's go on R1 next. From the CLI, I'll use Enable to enter privileged exec mode. Then, Configure Terminal to enter global config mode. Now let's set the host name with this command, hostname R1. Next, I'll configure the interfaces. First, G01, which is connected to the internal LAN. Interface G01. Let's set the IP address. IP address 192.168.1.254, 255.255.255.0. And how about a description? Description to switch 1. Finally, let's enable it. No shutdown. Next, the G00 interface connected to R2. Interface G00. I'll set the IP address. IP address 192.168.12.1, 255.255.255.0. Next, the description. Description to R2. And let's enable it. No shutdown. Okay, let's check on the interfaces. Do show IP interface brief. Okay, you can see the IP addresses we configured. G01 is up, but G00 is up, down. That's not a problem. It's just because R2's G00 interface is still shut down. Now let's go on R2. Enter privileged exec mode with enable, then configure terminal. Set the hostname, hostname R2. Next, I'll configure G00, which is connected to R1. Interface G00. Set the IP address. IP address 192.168.12.2, 255.255.255.0. Then the description. Description to R1. Now let's enable it. No shutdown. Okay, now I'll do the same on G01. Interface G01. IP address 192.168.13.2, 255.255.255.0. Description to R3. No shutdown. Okay, let's check on the interfaces. Do show IP interface brief. Like we saw on R1 before, this interface is up down because R3's interface is still disabled, but the rest looks okay. Okay, next let's go on R3. Enter privileged exec mode with enable, then configure terminal. Set the hostname, hostname R3. I'll configure G00, which is connected to R2. Interface G00. Set the IP address, IP address 192.168.13.3, 255.255.255.0. Then the description. Description to R2. Finally, enable it. No shutdown. Okay, let's do the same steps on G01. Interface G01. IP address 192.168.3.254, 255.255.255.0. Description to switch to. No shutdown. Let's check the interface's status. Do show IP interface brief. Okay, looks good. And the interfaces we configured are both up. Finally, I'll configure PC2. Click config, then set the gateway here, which should be R3's IP address, 192.168.3.254. Then click on Fast Ethernet 0 and set the IP address here, 192.168.3.1, and hit Tab to autofill the subnet mask. Okay, so we've done the pre-configurations, just some review of basic commands for practice. Now, let's get to the main point of this lab, configuring static routes. Before starting, let's think about what static routes we'll have to configure. We need two-way reachability, so PC1's ping can reach PC2, and then PC2's reply can reach PC1. R1 is already connected to the 192.168.1.0/24 network, so it just needs a route to 192.168.3.0/24. Likewise, R3 is already connected to 192.168.3.0/24, so it just needs a route to 192.168.1.0/24. R2, however, is not connected to either of those networks, so it will need routes to both. So that means a total of 4 routes need to be configured, one each on R1 and R3, and 2 on R2. Let's go on R1 and configure the first of the routes. We have to be in global config mode, so I'll type exit to get out of interface config mode. Configure the route with this command, IP route, and let's use the context-sensitive help to check the options. So it says destination prefix, meaning the network address, which is 192.168.3.0. Use the context-sensitive help again, and next is the mask, which is 255.255.255.0, since it's /24. Next, we can specify the forwarding router's address, which is the IP address of the next hop router, or we can specify the exit interface. All of these options are interface types. I'll specify the next hop address of R2, which is 192.168.12.2. If I use context-sensitive help again, you can see there is another possible option, distance metric for this route. I'll talk about this option in a later video, but this CR down here means we can just enter the command as is. Okay, now let's check out R1's routing table. Do show IP route. There's the static route we configured, as indicated by the S here. You can also see the configured and local routes for R1's two interfaces. Remember, the local route is the actual address configured on the interface, with a /32 mask, so it specifies just that single address. And then the connected route is the network address of the network the interface is connected to. Okay, R1's route is done, let's go on R2. Again, exit to get out of interface configuration mode. Let's configure the route to 192.168.1.0/24. IP route 192.168.1.0, 255.255.255.0, and then just to practice the other option, I'll specify the exit interface instead of the next hop IP address, G00. This message comes up, but you can ignore it. It says, if not a point-to-point interface. However, this is a point-to-point interface, meaning it connects only to one other device. This is different than, for example, many routers connected to a single switch, which we would call a shared segment. Anyway, don't worry about that for now. You can just ignore this message. Okay, next, let's configure the route to 192.168.3.0/24. IP route 192.168.3.0/255.255.255.0, and this time let's do the next hop IP address, 192.168.13.3. Okay, let's check the routing table. Do show IP route. Okay, here are the two static routes, and the connected and local routes for each interface. Looks good. Finally, let's configure R3's static route. Type exit to get out of interface config mode, and let's configure a route to 192.168.1.0/24. IP route 192.168.1.0/255.255.255.0 192.168.13.2, setting R2 as the next hop. Let's check the routing table. Do show IP route. Okay, looks good. One static route, and the connected and local routes for each interface. Now let's go on PC1 and try out that ping. Click on desktop, then command prompt. Okay, so this is the moment of truth. The first ping might fail due to ARP, Address Resolution Protocol, but once ARP is finished, the rest of the pings should work if we configured everything correctly. Let's try. Ping 192.168.3.1. Okay, looks like PC1 is able to reach PC2, and PC2 is able to reach PC1 with its reply. We have successfully configured static routing. That's all for this lab. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and share the video with anyone else studying for the CCNA. If you want to leave a tip, check the links in the description. I'm also a Brave verified publisher and accept BAT or Basic Attention Token tips via the Brave browser. That's all for now.